we make it as easy as one click. So that means there's no like engineering or technical work required. The AI is doing is it's going to look at the collection of data. It's going to recommend certain types of visualizations that can be done. And then it's actually going to start creating these visualizations in real time. So it removes a lot of the thinking that you might have to do normally in order to start to make sense of the data.
Welcome everyone to this next episode of the Analytics Tool Demo, where we show you the latest tools in AI and no code. Today I'm joined with Marcus Ellison from Breadcrumb. Hi Marcus.
Hi, happy to be here.
Glad to have you on the show. Can you tell us a little bit about Breadcrumb? So what is the tool doing?
Absolutely. So Breadcrumb is the most advanced AI analysis platform. So we're completely no code for business users and completely end to end. So underneath the hood, we have AI agents, about 12 of them right now, that are building and managing data pipelines. But from the user's perspective, they just drop in spreadsheets, can connect to databases or applications. And then Breadcrumb will automatically do all the data cleaning, ingestion, for you to prepare for analysis. You can just sort of like ask questions of the data, and then you can generate dashboards, reports. We pride ourselves on being really like the only business ready, production grade, like end-to-end AI analysis solution. So that means completely automating like the data work and reporting workflows for like B2B communication with data.
Super cool. And so I can imagine every business function nowadays needs data to make informed decisions. Do you have any particular functions that use Breadcrumb more than others, or typical use cases that we would use the tool for?
Yeah, definitely. So one interesting use case that we have is we have a reality TV show. But essentially what it is they get all this different data from their different media. So say like YouTube. And what they want to do is they want to create customized reports for different brand sponsors. So normally this takes like a bunch of like data wrangling in order to like combine different data sources and then turn those into like reports. But they can actually have an end-to-end solution in Breadcrumb where they actually build the reports. And then what you can do in Breadcrumb is you can actually have like the end reports, like the sponsors can actually ask questions of those, or you can invite them to like the different spaces. They can ask questions and get answers. So for them, the value is that they actually like increase the personalization and then also they decrease the amount of time that they're spending on, say, like customer support.
Amazing. I guess I have more questions once can take a look at the platforms. Yeah. Do you want to share your screen and show us Breadcrumb?
Absolutely. Let's jump into it. So I'm going to start. This is actually a example of like a consumer packaged goods company. So think like they have a chocolate supplement. They sell to Sephora and Whole Foods. And for their use case, what they're trying to do is they actually get different data from like Whole Foods and Sephora, and then they actually have to create reports back to these companies. And I'm going to go through like an end-to-end process and just show like how that works. So right here we have two different, this is sort of like raw data. And one is from like Sephora sales, and one is from like Whole Foods. And normally what you'd have to do if you were to use sort of other existing tools is you have to make sure that you have the a clean, well-formatted spreadsheets in order to even like start the analysis process. Breadcrumb will actually like do that for you. You have to make sure that you don't have additional like headers or like computed cells. You might have to create different columns. You might have to make sure that all of the same types of data within a column are the same. And so I'm just going to jump into Breadcrumb and then I'll show you how that works. In Breadcrumb, I'm going to go into our sources. You can see that for us, we can connect to a bunch of different sources. Applications, spreadsheets, databases. We make it as easy as one click. So that means there's no like engineering or technical work required. I'm going to go to these files and we're going to create a space. First, I'll click on one of them you'll see that every time you upload a data source, we actually are going to automatically perform cleaning actions, as well as do what we call semantic enrichment. But essentially what that means is we're just preparing the data for analysis. So you can see on this first spreadsheet, Breadcrumb removed empty rows, did some data conversion, numeric conversion, renamed columns. So this happens automatically, saves a lot of time on a per file basis. I'm going to jump in and actually just create a space. So here I'm going to click on a few different data sources, the Sephora and the Whole Foods. And then I'm just going to hit create space.
And basically, so those files are that you just showed, they, so if I'm an Excel user, they should be stored on a particular drive folder that we've connected, or is there also, did you upload them to Breadcrumb?
That's a good question. You can just drag and drop, or if you want sort of like an automated refresh, then you can put it into a Google Drive folder. So you have sort of like either option there.
Okay.
And then what I did when I clicked the button, so our AI agent is performing sort of like a multi-stepped prompting that you might have to do as you, if you're using something like Claude or ChatGPT. But what we do, so what the AI is doing is it's going to look at the collection of data. It's going to recommend certain types of visualizations that can be done. And then it's actually going to start creating these visualizations in real time. So it removes a lot of the thinking that you might have to do normally in order to start to make sense of the data. And then you can see that, go ahead. Yeah.
We didn't specify any analysis to perform.
Nothing at all.
That mode is, I just upload the file and even the thinking is outsourced to an agent in this case. Is there a way also to enforce certain analysis if I'm interested in particular insights?
Absolutely. What I didn't show in the previous screen was you can actually enter a goal or a context, and that will drive the generation. But then also what you can do is you can add additional insights, or you can adjust whatever insights that have already been created. So for example, we have some suggested insights, and you know, I can just go and like create a few of these. I could ask a question, that I, you know, myself. So you can see there are some sort of like pretty complex visualizations that are created, like unit sales by region. These are fully kind of like drag and droppable. So you can essentially ask any question. And then we're doing a translation of whatever natural language question that you have. We're going to figure out how to actually not just prompt, but write the Python and SQL code with AI agents. So underneath the hood, Breadcrumb is performing the work that a data scientist will go through in order to properly analyze the data. I'll zoom out for a little bit. So now we have like one dashboard. We could easily create like multiple different groups in order to like facilitate more exploration. I'll go to our sort of reporting view. And of course, like, feel free to stop me anytime. But so we have like, for if you want to generate like an actual report, we have AI generated summaries of each of the different insights. You can quickly sort of click on like publish.
The report is a single chart, right? And a dashboard is going to be a collection of reports?
A report is a collection. So this is actually what you're looking at right now.
Okay. So what you were creating.
Got it. And not only is it a collection, but you can, for our customers, I mentioned some, they want their customers to be able to ask questions of the report. You can actually just go into this box and they can ask any question that they would want, but it's kind of like you could think of it as like a read only view, where like with whatever question, if you created the insight previously, then it will answer it. If you haven't, then it won't have access to any of the other data analysis.
So you can answer on any, it can utilize any of the data that's been used for generating these insights, but it won't go beyond that.
Exactly. Gotcha. And then I'll show you just like a few other sort of like examples that's a little more complex. Here's like a recruited like a sample retail operations space, and you can see here we have like a number of different dashboards in the same space. You know, order performance and metrics overview, home office segment, corporate segment. And then a few things I want to mention is that the right now, like with a lot of tools, there's a limit on sort of like the data volume. Breadcrumb can, you know, you could have like the equivalent of like millions of rows, you know, like hundreds and hundreds of columns of data. You know, like you could have like 20 different data sources that you're connecting, and this just becomes sort of like your playground to explore the analysis. And then, you know, share with other team members or, you know, with other business partners.
Yeah, pretty wild. And in terms of data visualization options, so I see you have the usual suspects. Can you show us like what are the options there? So we have bar charts, you have donut charts, I guess pie charts and the likes, but what else is there for us to explore the data, visualize it?
I mean, there's a number of different, you can essentially sort of ask the AI, but in terms of, the AI will try to default to what it thinks makes the most sense. So we have, from this chat, I click on here, customers. We actually have a number of different like formats out of the box where you can have it like, displayed as like a table, or just like plain text, or, you know, of course like line charts, pie charts. So this is like out of the box. And for us, we've, we can actually, if you were like, oh, we would, you know, you could actually create like Gantt charts, you know, you can create like heat maps.
Things that are more custom.
Yeah.
This would be a custom build from your side, or is it also something that you can prompt the AI in the background to generate for you?
What I mentioned, you can just tell the AI, like, you know, I want to view it like this. And if it can do it with the data, then it will do it. If you do run into something that's, you know, not supported, then it's pretty easy for us to, customize. So, you know, we like to work with customers on, you know, like exotic or like new use cases.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. I already have in the usual suspects, like, in terms of chart. So it was very, very impressive what you showed us, Marcus. I think we created a report out of two Excel files in, you did, in less than a minute or or two. And we're just waiting that the agent creates the dashboard for us. So fairly impressive. Mm-hmm. I have two more questions. First, maybe on the direction the product is taking, what are the next steps, what are the next important features the team is working on?
So we're really leaning into our customer requests. So like we're increasingly like consultants, agencies, we're seeing how they can support them and support like, I guess, new experiences in engaging with data. So that's like more robust, like chatting with data. That's like, for us, that also means expanding the types of like visualization agents that we have. So that's really big. A little bit further on the roadmap is actually the different AI agents that we have, like exposing them so that we can say work with different companies that are just like, we just want to use your sort of like a data cleaning agent or like your visualization agent or you know, things like that. So for us, that's really exciting. But I think like, it's really just, we want to nail like literally be just the best way. If you want to report like between businesses with data, then we're just the fastest and simplest solution that's out there. So you saw that happened in a minute. It's just like tackling more and more complex use cases. More, when I talk about visualization, what I mean is like more templates, right? So you look at the, that end report, that's just a template. But like, what if you want something that's more catered to like your brand and your business? We want to make sure that we are like aligned with the customer as much as possible. And then just like saving time on existing workflows.
Any important integration that you're working on as well?
Yeah. So we're actively doing more integrations that are sort of like databases. So right now, a lot of what you see with Breadcrumb is like small data in, small data out, say like spreadsheets, small data. We're doing more stuff with, you know, MySQL, Postgres databases. Snowflake is an integration that's up there, as well as like on the application side. Right now we'll have like, you know, we have like Stripe, and like a number of other like payment providers, but we want to make sure that we're catering to like the ecosystem of data sources that any given company is like using. So for us, it'd be like your subscription business, we plug into all your different like data sources, and then we can be like a source of truth, you know, for you, or like, for like, between different departments.
Rochelle. Exciting. I think this is really one step forward towards business users being their own data analysts, querying the data. I think 15 years ago when I started working, whenever I needed insights, I needed to go to a BI team and to wait an afternoon to get a pivot table with data because it was really hard to retrieve. Yep. And then I had to chart it myself. I had to do a PowerPoint. And 2 days later, we had an output. Now I can see that what I used to do, you just done in 1 minute. We're having a nice conversation with me. So there's some progress there. But it's really a major step towards empowering your businesses in taking action on their data and not having data piling up and just not being able to draw insights from it because we don't have a data analyst or we simply don't know how to analyze data. Or as you pointed at the beginning of the video, there's just so much time lost in cleaning up files. It's a very, very impressive demo, very compelling product. Mm-hmm. Very excited that you could showcase Breadcrumb in the show. Last question, how do we get our hands on it?
Yeah, I'm just going to share my screen again for a moment.
Don't tell me there's a free tier. There is.
There. So we do have a free tier. It's limited, but it's like you can drop in, you know, spreadsheets, CSVs, start playing around with Breadcrumb, asking questions. Certainly like Breadcrumb gets more powerful if you have like existing, you know, like for us, like the best customers, like someone who's like they have like, you know, 20, 40 more, you know, different like customers that they need to do reporting for, marketplaces. But like, you can absolutely like play around, and just like whatever types of like analysis that you want to do very quickly. You can just try us out.
Yeah. Amazing. So go on Breadcrumb's websites. Get an Excel file you don't want to clean up, upload it, test it out, and see the product in action. You have no excuses now. Thanks a lot, Marcus, for joining us. It was really a pleasure and very compelling tool again. And that was the episode. Cheers.
Thanks, Alex. Cheers.